two of our Fave 10 faces star alongside heavyweights Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart in the Aussie version of DC League of Super Pets.
The Aussie pair play guinea pigs in the DC flick that's centred around the adventures of besties Crypto, voiced by The Rock, and Superman Watch.
We'll help you get your dumb owner back.
Ace, deploy canine shield.
What is a canine? And I should warn you, I'm 1/8 boxer.
And 7/8 chihuahua.
We actually went to the gym together last week.
You and I?
No, The Rock.
Oh, the Rock. You and The Rock?
Yeah, it's not.
Did you spot him?
Yeah, we spotted each other.
Do you bench the same stuff?
Similar.
Do you?
Yeah. We are real guinea pigs.
Oh, actual guinea pigs.
Yeah.
I've got two false teeth down the bottom, and when I put them up in the centre of my mouth, it looks like a guinea pig.
Are you sure about this? I mean, the kidnapping, we could get behind. Is that diabolical enough? Hey, girl! I hate myself, but I love the line.
That seemed incredibly painful.
Oh, yes! Oh, Aussie awesome. Vet Dr. Chris Brown and comedy queen Julia Morris joined us on the game! Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, my beloved and
thank
I.
you.
I mean, we've actually started couples dressing, haven't we?
We have. Same colour.
We didn't. We like literally came from the private home, different private homes this morning, and here we are side by side.
I love the fact you had to clarify.
Different private homes. I think it was any other way. I've been trying to drum up that rumour for years. It just never takes.
Can I just say, I saw this yesterday. The kids loved it.
Yeah.
Absolutely adored it. It was so much fun. What was it like to voice characters in a major animated blockbuster film?
Well, we couldn't believe it.
Yeah. It's one of those, I wouldn't say it was a bucket list thing, because who in vet school thinks you're going to be giving a voice to a character guinea pig? So, possibly.
Well, I was just saying, I've got a lot of fur that's been gathering around my face since I turned 50, so it's not a huge leap for me to then play a guinea pig.
That's Julia, though, full method.
Yeah, that's it.
She really commits to a role.
Do I get involved? I do get involved.
But recording the voice, it's kind of odd, but kind of cool. You're in a room, it's a studio, but the timing, you have to time your words with the guinea pig's mouth moving, and so the little sounds, your first word has to land on a particular point, otherwise the timing's out.
Well, there's also the no-pressure moment of the other people in the film are Dwayne Johnson, Kevin Hart, Keanu Reeves, like... I don't think we suffered in comparison. I think we fitted right in, actually.
No, I mean on the WhatsApp group, The Rock.
They're
very complimentary about our work.
They're like Dr. Chris and his grandmother are in the film in Australia, which is lovely.
It's Kevin Hart. He liked what we did. He didn't see how we could get the character to that point, but he.
So are you pebbles to Dwayne's rock then?
Oh, jeez.
Oh, I love that.
I like it.
We do get to say now for the remainder of our career, we've only totally done a Hollywood movie with The Rock.
That's it.
Exactly, yeah.
So that's pretty good on the resume. But it was...
DJ.
As you can imagine, it was a thrilling experience to even be asked.
Oh,
because we always talk about what a great team The Rock and Kevin Hart are. You rarely see them on their own these days, but you two are an unbelievable partnership as well. Did they give you any tips? Is that the way it works? Or are you just kind of, you're in it together? Just you two?
Well, I guess we sort of was in it together, weren't we? The guys had already recorded all of their part of the movie, and then so when it came time for us to record ours, we were given a nice bit of free rein to watch our little characters on screen and bring our own special something.
Do you know what's really cool?
Did they go with a voice first? Or did you just use your own voice? Were you tempted to kind of...
I said, look, they've reached out to the shareholders to pay us. I think we're going to bring our own voices on the day.
And I think it's kind of... I love the fact it makes zero sense that the guinea pigs are Australian.
I know, but I kind of loved that as well. Like, to hear this really crisp Aussie accent. I loved it. It was awesome. So you play Mark and Keith.
That's right. I'm Keith.
I'm Mark. Hi.
And the doctor is made of fire. I am made of liquid. And therefore, that's why I think I can be called Keith in a fluid situation.
Yes. mod. That's how we're explaining it.
Do you love how I've tied that back? I didn't even. That's just come to my mind right now.
That did contribute to many awkward conversations on the way home.
Yes, right.
From my kids.
Oh, why should? Why am I called Keith?
Why was the guinea pig called Keith?
Yeah. Well,
but she had a lady's voice. That's what I and I had. That was hard to explain.
Keitha. Yeah.
Okay.
You know what? Give them Julia's number and they can give her a call later on this afternoon.
I reckon too.
I'd like to hear her explain that.
And to be fair, a lot of the time I sound like a bloke anyway, so the jury could have been out as to exactly, you know,
The other thing I got hit with is, what's the difference between a guinea pig and a hamster? I don't know. Yeah. What's the difference?
What's the difference between a rat and a mouse? They're just different species altogether. Ooh. Hamsters, though, are legal in Australia.
Can't
have a hamster in Australia.
Why? Yeah.
Because there's always a risk of. I think rabbits did no animal favour by becoming a plague. I think they thought that hamsters would do the same thing.
A hamster's busy with relations.
They get very busy with relations in the same way guinea pigs do as well.
Right.
But rabbits have the reputation. They got so busy in the 18th century, they just. Everything just went off.
This is only going to lead to many more questions.
My kids want guinea pigs now as well. So thanks very much, you two.
Oh, I mean, no. they're not
Christians. They live 4 to 7 years. I looked it up.
They never go to God. Just let me put it this way. They never go to God. They just hang around.
Oh, tell me about it. I had them.
Very unlike me in my career, actually. They just never go.
We love you guys. It's so great to speak to you again. DC League of Super Pets is in cinemas everywhere on September the 15th.
So good.
Family Fun Day sneak screening from September the 3rd. Dr. Chris and Julie, it's such a pleasure to talk to you again.
It's so good,
awesome.
Guys. And it's funny for the adults too.
It is.
It's so good.
On little levels that you know, only Julie can understand and explain.
You're getting there. Chipping away.
And you've got to be the coolest mum now, surely, of all the stuff that you've done. Is that just...
Impressing teenagers. I'm telling you, that is some high-level business.
Go. And you've got to step in with DC now, so the next Batman?
Well, I mean, maybe. With DC
he's
the whole
the job.
Time, don't worry.
He's got the job.
He's the original DC.
We love you too. Come and see us anytime.